Hey, anyone see Principal Weatherbee come out of the bathroom with toilet paper stuck on his shoe?
What a loser!
Don't you mean poor, old, and fat loser? That's the loser hat trick.
Mr. Weatherbee wakes each day before the sun. He boils his egg, making sure the yolk does not run, or he'll have no fun. Mr. Weatherbee, he gets dressed, picking out a tie.
Here we go, you got this.
This, he thinks, is the way to catch Miss Grundy's eye. But he knows she'd rather die.
Shit.
He goes to work, which is a school, so he feels rather caught. Not a man and not a boy, his life is rather fraught.
He neither teaches nor is taught.
He'll see Miss Grundy in the lounge, sipping her hot tea. If only he were the tea, so in her mouth he'd be. Her tongue so slippery. Mr. Weatherby walks the halls, the kids will ignore him. His loneliness unbearable, this life is wearing thin. Maybe tonight he'll make it in. A redhead boy he hates the most, but it's really jealousy.
Ouch.
For Weatherby'd like to be the one to have Veronica or Betty. Or Veronica and Betty. The face is practically the same, differing only by color of their hair.
He imagines their smooth young bodies.
He wishes he were there. Suddenly the school bell rings, waking him from his reverie.
He looks down at his urban pants, the erection plain to see. They all scream, look at me!
The news helicopter overhead circles endlessly. Gently placed in the police car is Mr. Weatherbee.
The monster Weatherbee!
I'm just a man.